With me here at Minds and Money in London this morning, I'm joined by Eric Zurrin from Shanta Gold. Eric, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Nice to see you. Been a significant couple of weeks for you. You and I didn't speak last week when you had this significant announcement out about a material increase to your reserves and resources. So probably a good place to start. Just tell me a bit more about what was in that announcement.
Yeah, I'm really glad I'm here because there has been a lot of updates over the last couple of weeks. So last week we put out an announcement. We've had a reserve increase. You know, we did it. We extended the mine life. Good news. So we announced we've added 135,000 ounces at 4.1 grams per ton to the mine plan. Great news, and I'll tell you why. Because for every year of mine life, we at this gold price, we generate $60 million of EBITDA. Now, to put that in context, our market cap is $80 million. Mm. So it looks pretty interesting from an investor perspective to try and get excited by these. The good news is this. We've been drilling 8,000 meters for the last 6 months. In Q4, we're drilling another 4,000 meters. And what we've said publicly is that we've had encouraging results from that drilling.
Right.
So we've intimated that we'll put an update out before Christmas, and we'll give the market another flavor for what we've been up to in the last the last couple of weeks.
So the fourth quarter, generally speaking, it's so far so good for you.
It is. So far so good. In another one of these updates we had was some VAT.
Indeed. And you're seeing a bit more of that cash come in?
We are indeed. Yeah. We had our first update. We put it out on November 4th. Again, against the odds, nobody believed we would get it, but we had a $1.4 million refund, and it's exactly what we said would happen. There would be Acacia resolved, the tax with Acacia and Barrick would be resolved as well, so that happened in October. The Acacia minorities were bought in September, the tax was resolved in October, and then in November, the first business day of November, we had a VAT refund, and so we are confident that more will come, but we will have to wait and see. So we'll put an update out probably at the start of January with our Q4 results.
And you're continuing to pay down your debt as well?
It's melting off the balance sheet, Andrew. At this gold price, it has come pouring off. So we will probably, without a doubt, we'll have a net debt improvement in Q4. That's good news because next year, as we've said before, and we'll say again, we will be net cash at some point on our balance sheet next year. So just to remind you, $80 million market cap. Every year we generate $60 million of EBITDA with no debt. Now that sounds pretty interesting to me.
Well, what do you reckon the market's missing in this story then?
Well, I think it's one of these ones that we'll just have to season. It'll have to take time. You know, in the market's defense, Tanzania did have a bit of a rocky road over the last 24 months. I really believe we're through that. I was last in country last week. On the ground, I can report things are very steady with us. You know, we're sticking to what we do well, which is produce gold. I'm not trying to do anything complicated or over creative. And the market will just come along with that. You know, and eventually, if the market doesn't appreciate it, the ultimate way, which we talk to our board about, is to start returning money to shareholders at some point. And that certainly can't be avoided in terms of the market attention.
Eric, good to get a quick update here at Mines and Money. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.